Hello and welcome to Argentina, the venue for round two of the MotoGP World Championship, and welcome to Inside the Paddock on Friday. I'm going to keep my introduction pretty short because Jorge Martin, as you can see, is being swarmed behind us. I'm going to just walk in this direction just so I can get the other side of the barrier for when he comes through, so I can doorstep him and grab a quick word from the Spaniard, because he was third fastest this morning. Good start to life for Martin as he looks to fight back from the crash in Portugal. Jorge, just a quick word. All good this morning?
Yeah, not bad. It was tricky conditions with, you know, always when we come to Argentina, it's quite complicated the first free practice, but we are fast, so not a big problem.
Foot's okay?
Yeah, a bit better. It's improving every day, so feeling comfortable for Sunday.
I've got a special co-host, Maverick. I'm going to go meet him now. Anything do you want me to ask Maverick?
Yes, a bit more slow on the F2, please.
Will do. Thank you, Jorge. Good to chat with him. Yeah, giving it away though, but we have got a very special guest to be my co-host for this Inside the Paddock here from Argentina, Maverick Viñales. We'll get to him in a second. Quickly, Johan, how was that? All good?
Yeah. Tricky condition at the beginning, and fortunately with the softer tire with the, on the rear, I did two good laps. So we need to work to find the pace, and I like this track, but with the Ducati since last year, it seems I'm struggling more than with the other bikes, so I need to really stay calm. Compared to last year, we have one more days of work, so that's maybe better for me.
Good to hear that the voice is sounding better as well. Johanna's got over the flu that he was suffering from in Portimao. So, caught up with the two Prima Pramac racing guys. And now, let's get to our co-host, Maverick Viñales, because he is the talk of the town. Fastest in the opening practice session of the day. I'm getting the hurry on here, so might have to get a rush. Sorry. Squeezing through so we can get a quick word with the main man, Maverick Viñales. Here he is, down here as well. Marco Bezzecchi is there. I might come back and chat with Marco, but I want to get our co-host a microphone to start off this special edition of Inside the Paddock. Here he is with all the fans, chatting away, getting photos. And once he's finished, I'll give him a special microphone. Maverick,
for me.
Just for you, my special co-host for Inside the Paddock. Must be happy with that.
Yes, not bad. I'm happy. It's just FP1, but the feeling is great, as in Portimao. Track is bumpy.
Yeah,
it's not on a best condition, but I was able to take out the maximum, so it's fantastic.
And you were speaking in a press conference yesterday about the relationship you're building again with Manu, home Grand Prix for him, so no pressure, you need to deliver.
Yeah, no, I mean, he has the pressure. He has to provide me the best weapon he can. And it looks good. I mean, we keep riding, we keep focusing. I'm trying to understand the new bike a little bit more, trying to be more one with the bike. And seems every lap I go faster and faster.
How much are you enjoying being here in Argentina?
I enjoy it a lot. It's a very nice place, nice people. Of course, it's very similar to my country, so I feel like at home. And nothing else. I love the track, it's very nice, so I want to push and I want to go in the FP2 already.
It looks good. Are you going to stay with me for the show, or do you need to get the leathers off?
No, it's okay.
Okay, let's go this way then.
Okay.
So,
lo vengo, no te preocupes.
You're now going to have to be a journalist for the next 5 minutes. So we're going to, hopefully, the idea of the show is if we see some riders, some team managers, we stop them, like Manu, for instance.
Manu, come here.
So we've got the fastest man in MotoGP and the fastest man in Moto2.
Yeah, but this guy is improving, eh?
Very much so. Manu, how was the opening practice session? Happy?
Yeah, pretty happy, because the lap times came not easy, no? Because always to be first is difficult, but I'm really confident with the bike, and this track I like a lot.
Maverick, any questions for Manu? Now that you're a presenter, a reporter, what do you want to know from Manu?
Well, he said very well that it's important in FP1 to be in front, because you see the weather is very unstable, so it's important to be inside the Q2. I think this is the priority. And when I was in Moto2, was a very complicated category. So I understand these guys sometimes struggle, but Manu is doing great. Already from the first year he was in the front, now he's showing a lot of speed, and yeah, I hope, when the first victory, when?
I hope this Sunday.
Yeah,
now we are working, and starting the weekend like this is very positive.
Great to chat
they
with you,
They have a
Manu.
Good teacher, eh?
Yeah, I know. Well, the best, eh? Well, in some regards, VR46, he's got a great team around him with Hileti Nieto as well. Manu, great to chat with you. Good luck this afternoon. Good to chat. As we walk through, a few people wanting.
Where do you want to go?
Why don't we chat with Michele Messini? Who? Michele Messini of Grassini Racing, team manager there. Because Alex Marquez started pretty well, I thought. Fifth overall. Closest to. I caught up with Jorge Martin before I found you as well.
Okay.
He had a quick word for you.
Jorge?
Yeah, he said he wants you to slow down.
No. His bike is too fast in the street. And he's so fast at one lap. So.
Oh, Michele's just run away. Oh,
the
here we
one,
go.
The first one.
Let's have a look at this. We're in Argentina. We've got to have the World Cup trophy. Lionel Messi is La Cabra, no? Lionel Messi?
The best.
Of all time. Of all time. Oh, the same as
Maverick. Valentino, yo todavía estoy ahí.
Un saludo para Pau.
Venga. Okay. Un saludo.
Quick photo live.
Pau.
There we go.
Un saludo para Pau.
Hi, Pau. How are you? Hola. All good. Good to see you. The fans here in Argentina are super passionate, Mav, aren't they? It's great to see them all.
They are. They have, you know, like this Latin
the spirit,
blood, you know?
Yeah, the spirit.
Yeah, exactly. It's hot. Even if it's cold, you can see the people is pushing. Eh?
I know. Just talking about the action on track.
Yeah.
How important was it to have a good start like that? Because the wind's picking up, the clouds look grey, we might have rain.
The key is to be inside the Q2. So even if you need to try, even if you are P9, it's good because you never know. Maybe this afternoon rain, you cannot do well. You are already in Q1. The weekend goes a little bit on the other way. So, yeah, it was great to start, feeling good, feeling fantastic with the bike. Where I left in Portimao, so that's great. Different tracks, different weathers, and the bike is working, so I'm really happy.
Picking up where you left off, we've spoken about the journey it takes to get here. I've had to fly Barcelona, Madrid, Buenos Aires, and then up. A lot of Netflix. What are you watching on Netflix to keep you company?
I have to say that I give up a little bit on the...
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, on the phone and all the stuff.
Yeah?
Yes, I'm trying to read a little bit more.
Yeah. What were you reading?
Look, to be honest, I don't have too much time.
Yeah.
Of course, on the flying, yes, but at home, I train so much. I'm with my family. I take care with my two babies. And, man, you know, I have one dream, man. I need to work so hard, and I'm doing it, so...
So what do you do on the flight then? I imagine you've got some books.
I sleep.
Yeah?
Yeah, of course, because at home I don't sleep. So
Good point.
Take the profit to sleep. I sleep all the flight here today. I sleep, I don't know, maybe 12 hours. I try. Then when I go home, I need to switch with Raquel the nights. And it's not easy to be training really hard, don't sleep so much. But it's okay.
That's the difference. One man asking without any children, a man with children who doesn't understand.
See, we start to go a little bit purple here.
I know. It'll come with time. How are the girls? All okay at home? Of course, you've
got okay.
A new arrival coming
yes,
as well.
Yes, for July.
For July.
So, yeah.
Time, right in the summer break.
Yes, exactly. We are perfect on time. But yeah, it's so great, you know, when you have family, it becomes your priority.
Yes.
So everything else doesn't matter.
I know.
Until your family is fine, the rest is okay.
I'm sure you can appreciate how much Jack Miller's life is changing at the moment as well in the space of a few months.
Not yet.
Wait, it's about to come.
Yeah.
Married, now with a baby on the way. Does it change you how you look at the sport and how you look at your job?
I will give him some advice.
Yeah.
But it changed a lot. I mean, my mentality didn't change. I just become stronger because, you know, I have a lot of power. Always I had a lot of discipline.
Yeah.
You know, in my career there was ups and downs, but somehow now I create a good line. I'm really stable. I create a good group. My family is fantastic, you know. So we create a situation where I can show up my best, and this is fantastic.
Yeah, I guess that's the most important thing, having a surrounding, a group around you that just allows you to focus on the job and just the job.
Yeah, I think the most important is that it doesn't matter the result. Our objective and phrase of the year is we give the maximum with what we have. You know, if it's fighting for 6-6, 5-5, victory. And in Portimao, when I just... One rider take me out a little bit and I lost so many positions. I said, okay, if today I have to fight for 10, I fight. And at the end, I arrived fifth. So it was fantastic. I mean, motivation is high. team understand me really well. We create a really good atmosphere. We are calm. And it's a way of working, doing the same things and trying to replicate the results on Sunday.
Is that different for this year or a different version of the Maverick we've seen in years previous?
No, I will not say the different version, different. I will just say that I found the group. Yeah. I found a good group. They understand me. They give me what I need. The bike is competitive. So it didn't change too much, honestly. Just everything is more better, more competitive.
Yeah. We just walked past the world champion's box there, Pecco Bagnaia. Is he going to be the man to beat this weekend? Is he going to be
closest challenger? Of course, he will be the challenge. And yeah, we are working. We're going to make fight in the front, that's clear. And our objective is to fight with him, to fight with the front guys, and is what we are trying to achieve every weekend.
Looks good at the moment, though.
We'll see. We'll see. I'm calm. We need to understand, we need to work, and we need to keep pushing. So, yeah, it's fantastic.
Absolutely. Maverick, thank you for your time.
Thank you,
really
guys.
Really appreciate it. Brilliant thank to you. Have you on here. You. Come on, guys. Let's hear it for Maverick.
Thank you.
A lot of support this weekend.
Yes.
Well, you can see these guys. Big fans of Maverick. Yeah. So, hopefully, continue like we saw this morning.
Yeah, of course, it will. It will continue. We are working well. There is no point to continue fighting in the front.
Absolutely. I'm going to let this guy go and get some pasta for lunch. He needs to refuel ahead of a big practice session this afternoon. Mav, pleasure as always. I'll let you have the honours. You can sign off and say goodbye to everyone at home.
Okay. So, see you later. Goodbye. Bye. Okay.
Thank you, mate.